This former R.R. Donnelly printing site looks abandoned, unkept. The grass is growing up, the trees are untrimmed. While it produced old school media like printing copies of Reader's Digest and actual physical phone books, what's planned for here is on the cutting edge of new technology.
It's very exciting to start seeing people being mobilized and construction workers starting and demo starting as well.
It's only a matter of weeks before demolition starts on this site along Greenfield Road, preparing this warehouse space to support AI technology.
If you have a question on ChatGPT or if you want to create a resume or whatever, that's basically what's happening inside the data halls, is the machines is learning to create that content for you.
Racks of machines similar to these in another data center recently completed by technology firm Charisma.
It's long halls and each hall is 20 megawatts. It's kind of like a long bowling alley, basically.
It's a $6 billion investment in Lancaster County.
And I know that there is a mix of skepticism from resident and also excitement due to the scale of the economic development of this project.
Concerns include water usage, but planners say they will use air, not water, to cool the machines here. The site will have 72 diesel-powered generators, but builders say they've addressed noise concerns.
This facility will not add any noise to the closest residents on both ends, which are greater than 1,000 feet away.
The plant will have lithium-ion batteries for backup power, which carry a fire risk. But Fire Chief Todd Hutchinson says the city will require a top-notch fire suppression system. And Charisma says it's working with PPL to reinforce the power grid. Wolson Construction says work here will create 600 jobs. Running the data center will mean 150 permanent jobs, according to planners. Lancaster City and planners plan to host a town hall meeting to answer the public's questions and concerns in about a month. No date set for that exactly. A group opposed to the project is encouraging others who feel the same way to voice their concerns at tonight's Lancaster City Council meeting. In Lancaster, I'm Meredith Jorgensen, WGAL News 8.